Another useful algorithm in matrix algebra is the LU decomposition of a matrix. Basically, that is Gaussian elimination, but it allows us to factor a matrix into a lower triangular times an upper triangular matrix, which then makes a solution of a system of equations much faster. If you only need to solve one system of equations with one right-hand side, then it doesn't really make much difference. But if you have the same matrix, but you keep changing your right-hand side, like say you're evolving a partial differential equation, then LU decomposition can really speed up your code. So let's see how this method of partial pivoting applies to finding the LU decomposition of this matrix A. So what do we do first? In Gaussian elimination with partial pivoting, we have to go down the first column of the matrix and look for the largest element. That occurs with the 6 here. So we swap the first row and the second row. So this becomes 6 minus 6, 7, minus 2, 2, minus 1, and 3 minus 8, 4. So we use this permutation matrix, so we swap the first row with the second row, so I'll denote that as P12, permutation matrix, times A. Okay, so that's the first step, the pivoting step. Okay, now we do Gaussian elimination. So P12A goes to, let me do two steps of Gaussian elimination here. So we'll use the 6 to eliminate the minus 2. So the first row is 6 minus 6, 7. We divide through by 3 and add, so we get 0. Divide through by 3 and add, so we get 0. Divide through by 3 and add, so 7 third minus 3 thirds is 4 thirds. And then we get a 0 here. So we're dividing through by minus 2 and adding. So minus 6 divided by minus 2 is plus 3 and add. So we get minus 5 here. 7 divided by minus 2 is minus 7 halves plus 8 halves is 1 half. Okay? And then this was multiplication by two elementary matrices, so I'll call that M2 and M1 times P12A. Okay? So representing symbolically Gaussian elimination by multiplication by matrices. Okay, finally, the last step. We have M2, M1, times P12A. What do we do here? Now we look in the second column. Here, in fact, we have a 0 in the pivot. So that's never acceptable, even when you're doing this by hand. But we do the procedure of partial pivoting. We look down and find the largest in magnitude pivot. Here, there's only 1, and it's minus 5. And then we flip the rows. So we end up with 6 minus 6, 7, 0 minus 5, 1 half, and 0, 0, 4 thirds. And this one, now we flip the rows, so we flip 2 and 3. So that's P2, 3, M2, M1, P1, 2, A. Product of all of these matrices, the permutation matrices and the elementary matrices. And this final matrix then is upper triangular. So that's our U. Okay? So we've completed the Gaussian elimination with partial pivoting step. Now we want to find the L. The way we find the L is we want to do something to the M2, M1 so that it stays lower triangular matrix once we invert it. The trick we use is that P23 is its own inverse, so we can rewrite this equation as P23 times M2 times M1 times P23, again on the right. P23 is its own inverse, so we can get rid of P23 by multiplying by P23. And then P12A equals U. Okay? This may seem like a trick, but if you go through the matrix multiplication, you'll see that this matrix here is a very nice matrix, a lower triangular matrix, and we can invert it. So we can write this now as P23, P12 equals this matrix here, P23, M2, M1, P23, inverse times U. And this matrix here, if you compute it, is lower triangular. So this is our LU decomposition. And I dropped the A, please forgive me. P23, P12, A. Okay? This is our lower triangular matrix. I won't go through the matrix algebra on the board, but you can look at my notes, or you can do it on your own. What you find is that this lower triangular matrix then are the multipliers that we used to do Gaussian elimination. It's a 1, 0, 0, a 1 half, 1, 0, and a minus 1 third, 0, 1. Our upper triangular matrix we already have on the board is this one, is our 6, minus 6, 7, 0, minus 5, 1 half, and 0, 0, 4 thirds. Okay? That's our LU decomposition. MATLAB may not exactly write it like this. MATLAB might write it, I mean, you have an option in MATLAB to write it in this way, but MATLAB will also, by default, will put the permutation matrices on the right rather than on the left. So we multiply on the left by P23 and then again by P12, and we can get A equals P12 times P23 times L, this matrix here, times U. So this is just a permutation of the rows of L. You permute row 2 and 3, and then you permute row 1 and 2. What MATLAB says, which is probably the only place in the world that says that, except now I'm repeating it, is that this lower triangular matrix, which is a permutated lower triangular matrix, they use this phrase, this is a psychologically, if I can spell it, psychologically lower triangular matrix. Okay? If you Google that, you probably go only to MATLAB, and maybe later on you'll go to my notes. But it's a nice phrase. So with a psychologically lower triangular matrix, you can do your forward substitution and backward substitution. It won't be exactly forward substitution because the matrix, the rows will be permutated, but it will be something like that. MATLAB will do all the algebra for us, so we don't have to worry about this particular point. Okay, so the summary is that we can still do LU decomposition, even though we have an algorithm now where we interchange rows in order to avoid round-off error. It's nice to do one of these by hand to see how it works, but you know, we're talking about 1,000 equations and 1,000 unknowns. Let MATLAB do it. MATLAB does LU decomposition. MATLAB does Gaussian elimination. One of the simplest things you can do in MATLAB. Matrix laboratory. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.